HI means Health Informatics, and welcome to HiFi, which is Health Informatics in 5 minutes. The video is brought to you by Dash Simple Team, Health Informatics Rapid Design Lab at PHFI, Indian Institute of Public Health, Hyderabad. Please read the disclaimer carefully and then watch the video. Hi, welcome to video episode number 3 for software demonstration of Project Dash Simple, in short for Disability Assessment and Support Made Simple. This is a video series in which we will demonstrate step by step how to use a software that we developed for assessment of several types of disabilities. The software is best used on an 8-inch tablet. In this video episode, we will demonstrate how to do the test for assessing lower limb disability. The episode will be of 4 parts, and this is part 2. Hope you have watched the previous part 1 of the video episode. After the completion of 9 tests to assess lower limb stability component, you will automatically reach this screen where you can select the joint to be assessed in lower limb. As you can see, there are 3 options: hip, knee and ankle. In this video, we will demonstrate how to assess the hip joint for active range of movement first and manual muscle testing next. Please click on the hip joint to proceed. The next slide shows option for testing the right, left or both hip joints. Please click appropriately. When clicked, all the appropriate tests are lined up automatically in sequence. For demonstration, we will describe the assessment of right hip only. Please click on the right hip assessment to proceed. Test number 1 is flexion of hip. Please click on the plus icon to conduct the test. The Argon application will open up. Position of patient for this test is lying supine with hip and knee in 0 degree neutral extension and rotation. Position of assessor for this test is standing or sitting at the test site facing patient. Argon application open on the tablet should be held and positioned as an overlay over the joint to be measured. The central black dot of Argon should be positioned at the lateral aspect of hip over greater trochanter of femur as shown in the image. The red dot should be centered over the middle of lateral aspect of pelvis, and the yellow dot is positioned parallel to long axis of femur on lateral aspect of thigh. Knee is bent during the motion as shown in the guide image. The angle to be measured would be automatically displayed, and when you click the save or next button will be automatically captured in the database and the screen for the next test opens up. Test number 2 is extension of hip. Please click on the plus icon to conduct the test. The Argon application will open up. Position of patient for this test is lying prone with hip and knee in 0 degree neutral extension and rotation. Position of assessor for this test is standing or sitting at the test site facing patient. Argon application open on the tablet should be held and positioned as an overlay over the joint to be measured. The central black dot of Argon should be positioned on the lateral aspect of hip over the greater trochanter of femur as shown in the image. The yellow dot should be centered over the middle of lateral aspect of pelvis, and please slide the red dot parallel to long axis of femur on lateral aspect of thigh. Knee is bent during the motion as shown in the guide image. The angle to be measured would be automatically be displayed, and when you click the save or next button will be automatically captured in the database and the screen for the next test opens up. Test number 3 is internal rotation of hip. Please click on the plus icon to conduct the test. The Argon application will open up. Position of patient for this test is seated with hip in 0 degree neutral rotation and hip and knee flexed in 90 degrees. A towel may be placed under the distal end of femur to maintain it in a horizontal plane. Position of assessor for this test is standing or sitting at the test site facing patient. Argon application open on the tablet should be held and positioned as an overlay over the joint to be measured. The center black dot of Argon should be positioned on the center of patella of knee as shown in the image. The yellow dot should be positioned parallel to longitudinal axis of tibia on anterior aspect of lower leg, and please slide the red dot perpendicular to the floor following tibia as hip rotates as shown in the guide image. The angle to be measured would be automatically be displayed, and when you click the save or next button will be automatically captured in the database. And the screen for the next test opens up. Test number 4 is external rotation of hip. Please click on the plus icon to conduct the test. The Argon application will open up. Position of patient for this test is seated with hip in 0 degree neutral rotation and hip and knee flexed in 90 degrees. A towel may be placed under distal end of femur to maintain it in the horizontal plane. Other knee may be flexed so that the legs move under the table to allow motion without obstruction. Position of assessor for this test is standing or sitting at the test site facing patient. Argon application open on the tablet should be held in position as an overlay or the joint to be measured. The center black dot of argon should be positioned on the center of patella of knee as shown in the image. The red dot should be positioned parallel to longitudinal axis of tibia or anterior aspect of lower leg. And please slide the yellow dot to position it perpendicular to floor following tibia as hip rotates as shown in the guide image. The angle to be measured would be automatically be displayed, and when you click the save or next button will be automatically captured in the database, and the screen for the next test opens up. Test number 5 is abduction of hip. Please click on plus icon to conduct the test. The Argon application will open up. Position of patient for this test is supine, lying with legs extended and hip in 0 degree neutral rotation. Position of assessor for this test is standing or sitting at the test site behind patient. Argon application open on the tablet should be held in position as an overlay or the joint to be measured. The center black dot of argon should be positioned on placed over the anterior superior iliac spine. The yellow dot should be placed on line between two anterior superior iliac spine, and please slide the red dot parallel to the longitudinal axis of femur over the anterior of thigh as shown in the guide image. The angle to be measured would be automatically be displayed, and when you click the save or next button will be automatically captured in the database, and the screen for the next test opens up. Test number 6 is adduction of hip. Please click on the plus icon to conduct the test. The Argon application will open up. Position of patient for this test is supine, lying with legs extended and hip in 0 degree neutral rotation. Non-testing leg should be abducted. Position of assessor for this test is standing or sitting at the test site behind patient. Argon application open on the tablet should be held and positioned as an overlay over the joint to be measured. The center black dot of argon should be positioned over the anterior superior iliac spine. The red dot should be placed on the line between the two anterior superior iliac spine, and please slide the yellow dot parallel to longitudinal axis of femur over anterior of thigh as shown in the guide image. The angle to be measured would be automatically be displayed, and when you click a save or next button will be automatically be captured in the database, and the screen for the next test opens up. Test for manual muscle testing follows. The first test is for hip flexion. Position of patient for this test is short sitting with thighs fully supported on table and legs hanging over the edge. Patient may hold the table edge for support. Other hand of assessor stabilizes shoulder. Assessor instructs the patient to lift your leg off the table, hold it, don't let me push it down. If the patient has complete paralysis with no movement of the part and contraction cannot be palpated, grade 0 or 100% disability is clicked. If the patient has complete range of movements against gravity and takes full resistance, grade 5 or 0% disability is clicked. Complete range of movements against gravity with partial resistance means grade 4 or 20% is clicked. Complete range of movements against gravity with no resistance means grade 3 or 40% is clicked. Partial completion of room against gravity or completion of room eliminating gravity means grade 2 or 60% is clicked. No movement of the joint and contraction palpated means grade 1 or 80% is clicked. The assessor should note that only one option needs to be clicked, and when clicking, the assessor will notice changes in transparency on the clicked area. The assessor has to click the forward arrow in the bottom right corner to go to the next test. The second test is hip extension. Position of patient for this test is prone position with knees flexed to 90 degrees. Assessor's hand for resistance is contoured over the posterior thigh just above the knee. The other hand stabilizes the pelvis. Assessor instructs the patient to lift your foot to the ceiling, hold it, don't let me push it down. If the patient has complete paralysis with no movement of the part and contraction cannot be palpated, grade 0 and 100% disability is clicked. If the patient has complete range of movements against gravity and takes full resistance, grade 5 or 0% is clicked. As mentioned previously, in between grades of 1, 2, 3 and 4 are clicked for increasing percentage of disability. The assessor should note that only one option needs to be clicked, and when clicking, the assessor will notice changes in transparency on the clicked area. The assessor has to click the forward arrow in the bottom right corner to go to the next test. The third test is internal rotation of hip. Position of patient for this test is short sitting on table. Assessor places one hand at the medial aspect of distal thigh and applies resistance in the lateral direction. The other hand grasps the lateral ankle just above malleolus and applies resistance in the medial direction. Assessor instructs the patient to move your leg out and up, hold it, don't let me push it down. If the patient has complete paralysis with no movement of the part and contraction cannot be palpated, grade 0 or 100% disability is clicked. If the patient has complete range of movements against gravity and takes full resistance, grade 5 or 0% disability is clicked. As mentioned previously, in between the grades of 1, 2, 3 and 4 are clicked for increasing percentage of disability. The assessor should note that only one option needs to be clicked, and when clicking, the assessor will notice changes in transparency on the clicked area. The assessor has to click the forward arrow in the bottom right corner to go to the next test. The fourth test is external rotation of hip. Position of patient for this test is short sitting on table. Assessor places one hand at the medial aspect of distal thigh and applies resistance in lateral direction. The other hand grasps the lateral angle just above malleolus and applies resistance in the medial direction. Assessor instructs the patient to move your leg out and up, hold it, don't let me push it down. If the patient has complete paralysis with no movement of the part and contraction cannot be palpated, grade 0 or 100% disability is clicked. If the patient has complete range of movements against gravity and takes full resistance, grade 5 or 0% disability is clicked. As mentioned previously, in between the grades of 1, 2, 3 and 4 are clicked for increasing percentage of disability. The assessor should note that only one option needs to be clicked, and when clicking, the assessor will notice changes in transparency on the clicked area. The assessor has to click the forward arrow in the bottom right corner to go to the next test. The fifth test is hip abduction. Position of patient for this test is side lying with test leg uppermost. Lowermost leg is flexed for stability. Assessor stands behind the patient, his one hand providing resistance contoured across the lateral surface of knee. Assessor instructs the patient to lift your leg up in the air, hold it, don't let me push it down. If the patient has complete paralysis with no movement of the part and contraction cannot be palpated, grade 0 or 100% disability is clicked. If the patient has complete range of movements against gravity and takes full resistance, grade 5 or 0% disability is clicked. As mentioned previously, in between grades of 1, 2, 3 and 4 are clicked for increasing percentage of disability. The assessor should note that only one option needs to be clicked, and when clicking, the assessor will notice changes in the transparency on the clicked area. The assessor has to click the forward arrow in the bottom right corner to go to the next test. The sixth test is hip adduction. Position of patient for this test is side lying with the test leg uppermost. Lowermost leg is flexed for stability. Once leg abducted, patient brings leg back to normal position. Assessor stands behind the patient, his one hand providing resistance contoured across the medial surface of knee. Assessor instructs the patient to lift your leg up in the air, hold it, don't let me push it down. If the patient has complete paralysis with no movement of the part and contraction cannot be palpated, grade 0 or 100% disability is clicked. If the patient has complete range of movements against gravity and takes full resistance, grade 5 or 0% disability is clicked. As mentioned previously, in between grades of 1, 2, 3 and 4 are clicked for increasing percentage of disability. The assessor should note that only one option needs to be clicked, and when clicking, the assessor will notice changes in transparency on the clicked area. The assessor has to click the forward arrow in the bottom right corner to go to the next test. In this episode 3, part 2 of our video series, we have demonstrated how to conduct active range of movement first and manual muscle testing of hip joint. The result automatically stored in the database. The software will guide you to the next set of tests. At this point, there are two options. First, continue assessment for other joints or other type of disabilities. Or second, if the hip joint is the only one to be assessed, then exit and calculate the disability score. Please click the middle diamond icon once to bring you back to the joint index, or few more times to bring you back all the way back to the start index. In the start index, please click on the finish button to arrive at the disability score. For assessing other joints and other disabilities, please continue to demonstration episode 3, part 3. Or maybe take a break and come back to watch. Thank you for watching this episode. Project website is www.simple.in. The project and this video episode was made possible by a grant from Grand Challenges Canada. If you have any comments, please write to us at healthinformatics@iiphh.org. Also visit our website www.healthinformatics.in. Thank you.